Good morning and happy Sabbath. Okay, we're going to do that one more time. That was a warm up. Good morning and happy Sabbath to everyone this morning. We are going to sing some songs until everyone gets back. And we're going to start off with the hymn number 359, Hark the Voice of Jesus Calling. Voice of Jesus calling, who will go and work today? Fields are wide, the harvest waiting. Who will bear the sheaves away? Out and long, the master calleth. Rich reward he offers free. Who will answer gladly, saying, Lord, send me. If you cannot cross the ocean and the heathen lands explore, you can find the heathen nearer. You can help them at your door. If you cannot speak like angels, if you cannot preach like Paul, you can tell the love of Jesus. You can say he died for all. If you cannot be the watchman standing high on Zion's wall, pointing out the path to heaven, offering life and peace to all. With your prayer and with your bounties, you can do what help demands. You can be like faithful Aaron, holding up the prophet's hand. While the souls of men are dying and the master calls for you, going to continue with that hymn number 367, Rescue the Perishing.
Rescue them.
Good morning again. We are going to continue with the hymn 368, Watchman Blow the Gospel Trumpet. This time we're going to turn our attention to the screen.
Welcome to a church fire evacuation procedure. We take safety very seriously here at our church, and we want to ensure that everyone is prepared in case of an emergency. This video will walk you through the steps for safely exiting the building due to a fire. Please pay attention to the information on the screen.
In the event of a fire, a siren will be sounded. When you hear the alarm, you should exit the building immediately. Stay calm and do not panic.
Safety wardens will be positioned around the church. They will guide you to the exiting the building. You can identify the safety warden by the reflective vests.
Being aware of your exits is crucial during an emergency. Upstairs, there are three exits. Exit A, the vestry. Exit B, the side door. And exit C, the ramp. Note that exits A and B both have stairs. Those who have difficulty with stairs should use exit C. Downstairs, there are four exits. Exit A, through the children's room. Exit B, through the gate by the water cooler. Exit C, the front door. and exit D, the side door to Church Street. Note that the exits A, C, and D all have steps. Those who have difficulty with steps should use exit B. Remember to look around and identify the nearest exit. Note, the closest exit may be behind you.
After exiting the building, we will gather at a safe place away from the fire and smoke. We call this a muster point. Once outside, do not re-enter the building. Our primary muster point is Kensington Lodge. To get there, proceed up King Street. Remember, this is an active street, so keep to the left side. If the fire blocks our path to the primary muster point, then a secondary muster point will be used.
The safety warden will give this instruction. If no instruction is given, proceed to the primary muster point.
The secondary muster point is the car park of Westbourne Shopping Plaza. To get there, proceed down King Street to Baxter's Road. Again, remember this is an active street, so keep to the side. Once assembled at the muster point, the safety warden will account for everyone and instruct when it is safe to re-enter the building. We hope that this video has been informative and helpful.
Remember, fire safety is everyone's responsibility. Thank you for your cooperation.
All right, we are going into our announcements, but before we do that, we've been sitting for a while, so we're gonna stand and sing that welcome song, Why Don't You Greet Somebody in Jesus' Name. Why don't you greet somebody in Jesus' name? Why don't you tell them that you love them in Jesus' name? Tell them that we can work together in Jesus' name. Everybody smile. Jesus loves you. Everybody smile. Jesus loves you. Why don't you greet somebody in Jesus' name? Why don't you tell them you love them in Jesus' name? Tell them that we can work together in Jesus' name. Everybody smile. Jesus loves you. Everybody smile. Jesus loves you. God loves you and I love you, and that's the way it should be. Somebody in Jesus' name, why don't you tell them that you love them in Jesus' name? Tell them that we can work together in Jesus' name. Everybody smile. Jesus loves you. Everybody smile. Jesus loves you. Amen. Amen. We are going into our announcements, and our first announcement comes from the conference, and this is from the Community Services Department, Barrel Relief Phase 2. We now turn our attention to the screen. You're not. I guess not. But we would have heard this already. This is the project roof replacing original overlay firmly. And this is going to be in the countries of Karakou, Petite Martinique, and Union Island. And we are calling on all skilled volunteers, carpenters, masons, plumbers, technicians, electricians, joiners. If you're interested, you can contact our local community services leader, Sister Joan Watkins, or you can send an email to the personal ministries at eastcarib.org. So if you do want to assist or you can go, you can contact Sister Joanne Watkins or you can send an email to personalministries@eastcarib.org. Our next announcement is the countdown to the presidential campaign. Our president, Pastor Anthony Hall, will be hosting the Homes of Hope and Healing evangelistic campaign within our zone. Now, the campaign officially begins on October 25th, and it includes a series of activities leading up to the launch. Now, the first event is 10 days of prayer. Now, this began on Wednesday, so this will make today number 4. We're asking you to continue to uplift the campaign in your prayers, as well as the community of Lone Gap Grisettes. Please take note of this. Our first event, 10 days of prayer. Next, our announcements will be from our church. And first up, we have, drum roll, fellowship lunch will be served today after church. You know, last week we were on a break, but today we will have fellowship lunch after church. Now, this is a special thanks going out to all those who continue to contribute to the fellowship lunch provided every Sabbath, whether it be monetary donations, the food items, the actual meals. Most of us, if not all of us, have benefited in one way or the other from these church lunches. We really appreciate them, and we also appreciate you. And we just want to say a special thanks to everyone involved. Without you, none of this would be possible. And on that note, if there's anyone within the hearing of my voice that wishes to contribute to our fellowship lunch, you can contact Sister Alicia Andrews. Our next announcement is coming from our Pathfinder Club. There will be Pathfinder Club tomorrow, that's September the 8th, from 3 to 5 p.m. Pathfinders, please take note of that. Pathfinder Club tomorrow, 3 to 5 p.m. Tomorrow, we also have Bible School happening at 4 p.m. on Zoom. And this week, we're looking at chapters 20 to 23 in the book of Exodus, and it will be brought to us by our elder, Anthony Grandison. Please take note of that. Bible school tomorrow at 4, Exodus chapters 20 to 23. Our educational lessons also continue on Wednesday from 4 to 6 p.m. Our weekly reading, mathematics, and language lessons, they are resuming from this Wednesday. So if you know of a child between the ages of 9 to 11 who would benefit from these lessons, please see Sister Julianne Roach for more information. Our Wednesday night prayer pulse continues this Wednesday at 7 p.m. Come out in your numbers. You can join us on Zoom. You can join us on YouTube. And most importantly, you can join us here in person. 7 p.m. our Wednesday night prayer pulse. Now, next Sabbath, which is September the 14th, is our back to school Sabbath. Yep, next week's Sabbath is our back to school Sabbath. So we invite you to come on down, see what's going to be in store. But next week is our back to school Sabbath. Our next announcement is just a reminder from our community services department about our hurricane season contributions. Now, there's still time to contribute to the community services. And this year, our team is Storm, serving together, overcoming rough moments. And as you know, we are appealing for your generous contributions of canned items. You can give them directly to Sister Joanne Watkins, or you can place them in the collection box. Let's turn this storm into a powerful force of generosity and love. Our team is We Can Do It. Yes, we indeed can. Awesome. Our next announcement is coming from the AY Youth Society. And if you missed the first one, you only have yourself to blame. But there's good news. We'll be having another Bible Boom on November the 2nd, 2024, yep, at 4 p.m. And the chapters are Genesis 7 to 9, 11 to 15. Now, this week, we will be studying Genesis 8. So, plan to study for Genesis 8. And also, on November the 2nd, plan to be there. Plan for it. Will the Gideonites remain victorious, or will the warriors in Christ have a chance at taking the crown? It all goes down on November 2nd. In the meantime, study to show yourself approved. Coming up next on our AY, we also have our AY this evening continuing at 4:30 p.m. under the theme Joy and Happiness. Please walk with your devices to participate in the Icebreaker Challenge. Tell a friend to tell a friend, and see you at 4:30 this evening. Come out and be blessed. Now we move into my favorite part of the announcements, the birthdays. And on September 8th, we have Sister Angela Workman. Happy, happy birthday to you. Continuing on September 8th, we also have Saskia Griffith Bartlett. A happy, happy birthday to you as well. Coming up on September the 9th, we have Sister Maureen Patricia Gemmett, also known as Auntie Pat. Her birthday is going to be on September the 9th. A special and warm happy birthday to you. On September the 9th, we also have Brother Gerard Paris. We want to say a special happy birthday to him. And coming up on September the 10th, our very own AWA leader, Adam Octave. Happy birthday. Is Adam here? He's waving in the back. Happy birthday in advance, Adam. God's richest blessings. And ending this week, we have on September the 11th, Sister Sarita Armstrong. Think she might be downstairs. Oh, she's right here. She's hiding. Happy, happy, happy birthday to you in advance. God's richest blessings to all of the birthday celebrants. I pray you guys have an awesome birthday and many, many more. Many, many, many more to come. And I also want to say thank you for my birthday wishes. Yes. Now we move on to our thought for the week. We move on to our thought for the week. Now, this week I would have read something called The Butterfly. And it was about this man who saw this small cocoon. And, you know, the more he saw it, it had like a little opening. And, you know, he sat there and he was watching what was emerging out of the cocoon, and it seemed to be a butterfly that was struggling. And in his wisdom, he thought, you know, if you are struggling to get out, I think that I should be able, you know, to help you. So he went and he got a scissors, and he's, you know, cut open the cocoon, and, you know, trying to make the butterfly's life a bit easier. And the butterfly did come out, and he told himself, you know, that everything was going to be okay. And when the butterfly did emerge, the wing was kind of limp. But he told himself, you know, maybe after a while, you can catch by yourself, you can be good to go, and all will be well with the world. But to his surprise, the butterfly, its wing never recovered. It never healed. The butterfly's struggle to come out of the cocoon was necessary in order for the wing to fully develop. And, you know, sometimes we go through things in life, you know, some struggles, you know, some temptations, and you ask yourself, this really makes sense? You know, but, you know, that verse in James, I think it's chapter 2. Hold on. I think it's James 2:1-4. Is it that? Just give me a little minute. Sorry, the technology. Oh, no, it's James 1 here. Sorry. It's James 1, 2 to 4. My bad. And it says, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. Now, this is my thought that I'm leaving for this week, that we would endure through our temptations. We're going to stand at this time as the platform personnel make their way.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
You know, when I sat in the back to, well, my right now, your what would be your left, I was thinking to myself, church is looking so, I don't know, not well attended today, but from this vantage point, you guys are looking lovely. It looks like we have many people at church, so I am so happy to see you.
Amen.
Now, my task here this morning is to welcome you, all right? And something's dawned on me throughout this week, so I'm going to share the things that dawned on me with you as I welcome you. Romans chapter 14, verse 1 says, accept the one whose faith is weak without quarreling over disputable matters. All right? Romans chapter 15, verse 7 says, accept one another then, just as Christ accepted you, in order to bring praise to God. And then Luke chapter 9, verse 48 says, then he said to them, whoever welcomes this little child in my name welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me. For it is the one who is the least among you who is the greatest. Now, when I reflect on those three texts, I think that everybody in here can identify with some part. And I see that God has made not just Sabbath, but God has made this time, this place for each and every one of us. So my prayer is that as we sit and fellowship together today, that we would recognize that God has a place in here for each and every one of you. The song said there's a place for every worker. So my hope is that you are encouraged and that you're welcomed as we continue to fellowship at God's feet. Be welcomed.
Amen.
Our hymn of adoration today is 373, Seeking the Lost. 373.
While you're standing, let us reach for our Bibles as we turn to our passage for our text of for the scripture. So the text of reference today is taken from Mark chapter 16, verse 15. And you will listen as I read. And it says, "And he said unto them, Go ye therefore into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature." May God add his blessings to the reading of his holy word.
Amen. Be seated. Be seated.
Will the deacons and deaconess please come forward? Psalms 54:6 says, "I will sacrifice a freewill offering to you. I will praise your name, O Lord, for it is good." The deacons and the deaconess will now be honored for this morning tithes and offerings.
Eternal and most merciful Father, we want to thank you again for bringing us here into your house of worship. And as we come there, Father, and bring these tithes and offerings to thee, we pray that you will bless it, bless those who give and those who had not to give. We pray that someday that they would be able to give as well. So into your hand we commit this offering this morning and this tithe. It's my prayer for Christ's sake. Amen. Amen.
And so at this time, this is the time when we pray to God. This is the part where all of us can participate in our service to God by calling on Him. At the beginning, on Wednesday night, we were told that on behalf of the two upcoming evangelistic as emphasis programs that the church is expecting between Pastor Hoyt and Pastor Hall, on Wednesday we started 10 days of prayer for these programs. 10 days of prayer. And so we started on Wednesday night. And we are continuing to those 10 days. So because of that, at this moment, I want you will be doing it in two sections. I want you to choose a partner, and I want you to pray for the evangelistic program of the church. We want to remember Pastor Hoyt and Pastor Hall and every aspect of these crusades that will be. Pastor Hoyt's crusade will be starting in nearly 2 weeks from now, New Life. And we want to help support them. And then in October, Pastor Hall's crusade will start. So we want to pray that God will be with them. And we also want to pray that His Holy Spirit will pour Himself in the communities where we are going, so that men and women would accept our invitation and come to Christ. Now, I'm giving you 3 minutes between yourselves, after which I will close in prayer. So choose a partner as we pray for this program. After the prayer song, we will choose a partner, and then we will pray for 3 minutes, after which I will close, bring the choose a partner. Our Heavenly Father, we come before you thanking you for hearing the prayers of your children. Thank you for your forgiveness. We thank you for your mercy. I want to ask that you would answer the prayers that our saints poured out to you this morning, and so that your work will be successful in this part of your vineyard. Hear our prayer on the behalf of your servants and the evangelistic programs that is planned for this part of the world. We pray that at the end of it, great success will be had and many lives will be won to call you blessed. Now, dear Father, I want to bring the Sabbath school, the divine worship. You have been with us in the Sabbath school. As we went into the mission field, you have touched the lives of many men and women as we interact with them. And now as we come to finish the divine aspect of your program, we pray, dear God, that your Holy Spirit will come upon each and every one of us, use us in a mighty way, that your name would be uplifted and that men and women will be drawn closer to you. Be with the one who will give the message this morning to strengthen your saints. We ask that your Holy Spirit will use him in a mighty way. We pray that your Holy Spirit will touch his tongue with life coals from your altar, so that all of us listening, whether here, online, or even after in remembrance, we would heed the words of your manservant. Through the aid of your Holy Spirit, we will be blessed, we will be strengthened, and we will go forward telling men and women of your love and your soon coming. We ask your continued blessing on this nation. We ask that you will beat back the forces of evil that will seek to bring harm now, and as we continue into telling men and women about your love, continue to prepare and to keep your servants prepared until you should put in your appearance. And when we hear the words, "Well done, thou good and faithful servants," we would have known that we would have been faithful, living for you, setting the right example, and thus we are going home with you. So keep us faithful until the end. Keep us true to you. Hear our prayer. Thank you for hearing and answering, dear God, and for all these mercies. We praise your holy name for Christ's sake. Amen. Be seated. I want to, before we go into the other aspect, let's sit and sing the first and the last verse of hymn number 83. First and last verse of hymn number 83. This time, for the next 5 to 8 minutes, quickly, we don't have time. We have just come back from the community. For those of you who would have gone into the community, you might have had a testimony, and you might want to share with how God has used you to bless these men and women that we impacted their life by inviting them to come and taste and see the word of God. Anyone want to give a testimony of what went on in the mission field? We are satisfied? All right, let me tell you what about myself. And so as we went into the mission field, This morning we usually go in Hunt Street, and so we were privileged to share not only the priorities with these men and women, but we had an opportunity to let the people see that we think of them in every way. And thus we thought of their children as they were planning to go back to school. And so we presented on the behalf of the church some gifts of books and pencils to the children who will be returning to school. And the parents were truly happy to receive these gifts from the church. And so we invited them to come, having seen that we don't only think of their spiritual health, we also think of their homes and their children in that aspect. So it was a blessing to see their say thanks, but truly it was not enough because we had to promise others that we would bring back a few more to them. So anytime that the church, we recognize that anytime the church can be gift to the members in the community, they would realize that we are not only want to indoctrinate them spiritually, we are thinking of them. And you know that God used what we did this morning so that we can have a further wedge in their doors as we go continue to tell them about what God is doing for them. And then we were happy to see that some of the people that we accustomed going back to, it's a little over a month, we did not go back to these men and women, and a lot of them were truly happy to receive us back into their homes. Brothers and sisters, God was smiling as we saw the smiles on the faces of these men and women. I pray that we all of us who didn't get the opportunity to do it this month, that soon when we plan, because of the crusade that is coming up, we might need to go again sooner. So plan for that time again, two saints. God bless you.
Yes, I too would want to share a short testimony.
Go ahead.
As I was saying, we would normally carry out the priority. By extension, we would have carried the book, The Great Controversy, and other books we have, like the yearbook and so forth. This morning, it was a pleasure of mine through, I think, the education department to carry out a little package for them as well. They were pleasantly surprised, especially one particular lady. She was thinking of going next week. But when Fraser gave her the package, her eyes just opened up wide, and I said, yes. Mm. You know, there's another person that we would like to carry another one for, and we hope that that one will come true. But like you said, Trevor, you know, it's good to know that we can go to them and take care of some of their physical or educational needs as well, rather than going all the time and saying, well, Jesus loves you and he's coming again. It shows that we are a community church, and that we are also a church without walls. So I want to encourage the others to come and say something in regards to this. And those of you who would have been praying for us, we welcome it and continue to pray for us. Thanks very much.
Amen. Okay.
Yes, good morning. When we went out in the field this morning, I met this lady, the sister that was with us and brother. They know this lady, and she's a very nice lady, elderly lady, but I know one of her sons because I used to be in Kensington Lodge a few years back, and we used to like play football and stuff together. But it was a very joyful look on her face this morning, maybe present the packages to her for the children, the junior, the primary and the secondary one. And we also interact with her about the old days when people used to give gracefully without accepting money for fruits and other things. And it was a very blessed thing, you know. And God made it possible to let it happen, and I know that He would bless it all the way.
Amen.
Thank you.
My area is Lightfoot Lane. I was in Kensington Lodge, but they run me from there, and they have other people going there now, so I find myself back in Lightfoot Lane. Now, I have a few people over there who were glad to see us this morning, and they wanted prayer. But my thing is that the workers are few. People, they are dying. People are dying for the hope. Now, I have this gentleman, Mr. Keith Eargard. I invited him to the crusade in Goodland. And ever since then, he seems interesting in the message. He said that this morning, he said that he's 74 and he's having back pain. But I was just reminding him that the Bible says 3 score and 10, and God is giving him some borrowed time. And he agreed with that as well. I want the church to pray for Keith. I want to see Keith coming here. He promised me and said he will come to church. But he needs that extra push. So I'm praying that we here at church will continue to pray for these individuals. Not only Keith, but there are others as well too. I have a friend named June Blackman. She comes to the harvest and things like that, but she wants a little push. So I believe that we're going to have a prayer and fast sometime, prayer for these individuals, because if they're not having, getting through to them, in ordinary visits, and we got to pray and fast for these individuals, because they need to be free from sin. Need for the free, the devil has these people bound. They're not, nothing will stop them from coming on Sabbath mornings or Wednesday night, whatever, but the devil somehow had them tied up. So I'm praying that the devil will be, God will send angels to release them so they can come to knowledge of the truth. So keep Lightfoot Lane in your prayers. Thank you.
Okay. All right, this will be the last.
Mm-hmm.
This morning in the field, going out to get the packages, we went from Brother Ricky's class, burning a platform right there, Sean, myself, and I. As we was going about in the field, as I said, there was this young lady with a parent of the child. So we said, Sean, Bernie, let's go to her. So we went to her to give the package, for she was a primary school student. She was so excited and so blessed to receive the package. And she felt so, she was like so happy. She was all joyful. And praise, so I would say that God is good.
Praise the Lord. Okay. So we had great effect on the community this morning. And as you continue this Sabbath day, I want you to continue in prayer for that aspect of the work that we did today, that God will use it as a wedge to continue to soften the hearts of these men and women. As you hear Sister Colleen say, they need prayer. And I agree with her. I was talking to Sister Annie, Miss Annie. She was saying she works every day. She will not be able to come Saturday. She works from Saturday to Sunday. From Sunday to Monday, 7 days a week. And sometimes when she gets her off day, she has to do shopping. So we prayed with her that God will provide, help her to organize her way and provide some way for her to serve Him to us. But so yes, Satan has the people out there bound up, that they cannot find no way to worship Him. We need to pray and pray hard for these men and women. The next part of our service that we will be going into is that of hearing the word of God. And to present the word of God in a form of a sermonette, will be of our brother Ryan Kamabash. Critchlow, I was thinking of a man I work with. Sorry about that. Brother Ryan Critchlow. And so Brother Critchlow is a young man who loves God. And he has come to love him even more since giving his life to him. As you approach Brother Critchlow, you will recognize he will never say no in helping you in any way. And we pray that God will continue to bless his life as he surrenders his life to him and he gives to God that which God is requiring of him. I know God requiring more of Brother Critchlow from what I see of him. And so as he comes to give you his word, I pray that you will keep him in prayer and that the word of God will bless our hearts. However, before he does, we will sit and sing prayerfully number 567, the first and last verse, 567.
Church. Nice to see you from this point of view. You look lovely down there. I myself have a short testimony about out in the field this morning. We went to some individuals on the King Street route, which is not really the route that we use, but we used that and then we went to Kensington Lodge. But the people that we encountered this morning were very receptive about the message. Mm-hmm. We had our challenges, who we sometimes run into people who say they don't do a church. But I had to let them know we are not doing church. We are working for God. And we are here to bring the message of God. And not to dwell on church. Try to come and have a relationship with your maker. We also went to our regular people that we go to in Kensington Lodge as well. And there's a lady by the name of Angela. She visited here. She had a bad experience one Wednesday night. But she forgave us for what happened that night, thank God. And this morning when we went there, she was enraged and actually asked for prayer. And we were happy to know that we could be there at that time to give her a prayer. And after the prayer, she was like, "Don't worry, the two of you all don't leave me alone. One of the worst are my parents. I coming back to church." So I was thankful to hear those words coming from her mouth this morning. And I asked that God would continue to work on her and strengthen her on her journey. This morning, the title of my presentation is The Rescue Mission. Have you ever thought of yourself as a Navy SEAL in God's Army? A Navy SEAL is a very important soldier in the Army and is capable of executing a number of important tasks during a military assignment and in times of war. Before we explore three of these tasks, let us pray. O kind of Heavenly Father, dear Lord, as I come to you this morning, humble, dear Lord, I ask that you will use me, dear Lord, as your vessel. Hide me behind your cross, and let the words of my mouth be of you, dear Lord, that all the glory and honor will be given unto you this morning, I pray, in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Task one, handling insertions. This involves placing a Navy SEAL into a specific situation or location to handle certain missions. We, like Navy SEALs, have been placed in specific locations that comprises, for example, our country, community, job, schools. And we, too, are given a mission to perform. This mission is given to us by the great commander of the Lord's Army. He commissions us as Navy SEAL soldiers to handle this insertion, which is found in Matthew 28, 19, and part of 20. He states, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you." Fellow Navy SEALs, there you have it. The nations, that's the location. And baptizing and teaching them, that's the mission. Okay. Task two, handling extractions. These, on the other hand, often require that Navy SEALs remove hostages from their situations. In order to bring them to safety, doesn't the enemy of our souls often hold many civilians and soldiers alike hostage, who are caught in perilous traps of sinful lusts and desires? As God's Navy SEALs officers, we are expected to perform one of the greatest rescue missions of all times. We are expected to invade enemy territory and bring those caught in the snares of the enemy safely to the other side of our great commander, Christ Jesus. Task three, providing support. Navy SEALs sometimes work with other military units or groups to provide additional support or guidance as needed. This is done as the outset of a mission or backup if the troops on the ground require help with their work. Don't we, like Navy SEALs, work with other mission-oriented groups, such as ASA, in order to complete the great commission God has given us? Yes, indeed, we are God's Navy SEALs. We are soldiers of the Lord's Army. Amen. Now that we have established that we can be likened to Navy SEALs, let's through that lens examine one of the corporals of the Lord's Army. We all know the story of Corporal Jonah. The commander of the army has had a mission for him, just as he has a mission for us. Jonah's mission was to go to Jonah's mission was to go to and warn the people of Nineveh because their wickedness had come up to God. However, Jonah was not having that. What was not having that? Because he didn't think that those people of Nineveh deserved to be saved because of how they were living. Jonah believed that he knew who and who shouldn't be saved. Don't we also have the same mindset about certain neighborhoods that are known to be full of crime? How many of us believe also that some types of individuals won't be saved and never listen nor never change, and that programs such as outreach are just a waste of precious time and energy? But let me remind you that our great commander does not think like that. Romans 5:8 says, "But God commendeth his love towards us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us." Church, we were just like the Ninevites when Jesus came and died for us. We weren't worthy of his love, of his act of love, but God still saved us. He loved us. Aren't we expected to do the same as followers as Christ and Navy SEAL soldiers in his army? So like Jonah, we are also expected to obey the given command. God's work has to be fulfilled in spite of our own personal benefits or reservations. Church, praise the Lord. God has the final say, or I probably wouldn't be here. Now, as fate will have it, when Jonah decided to go AWOL from the Lord, God had to have him court-martialed. He imprisoned him in the belly of a great fish. How many of us experience negative consequences because we, like Jonah, want to have our own way instead of following the commands of our great commander? How much of us? How much? We tend to don't want to tell certain people about Christ because the place full of crime, there's raw people, the languages on there is a lot of French. But as we read, the Lord wants us to go and tell everybody about him. So we have to get a different mindset. I too, like Jonah, had been running from God for a while. I neglected to heed the call. I ran into many perils and misfortune along the way, but thank God that he keeps coming after us. I am here as a testimony of the fact that he is indeed the God of second chances. 2 Peter 3:9 reminds us that God is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. After Jonah had been in the fish's belly for 3 days and 3 nights, Jonah decided to obey the Lord and the great commander, reappointed him while he was still in the stomach of the fish. After being released from the military jail, or fish stomach, Jonah set out to do what God appointed him to do. He went straight into Nineveh and preached to the people of Nineveh about God and told them about the impending dangers that would result if they did not change their ways. You see what could happen when we continue to do what God tells us? This caused the king of Nineveh and the noble men to hearken to God's word and proclaim a fast and to put on sackcloth, from the greatest of them to the least of the Ninevites. Amen. So they all came to repentance, and God spared their lives. Hallelujah. He had performed a successful rescue mission. How many of us as Seventh-day Adventists are ready to perform God's rescue mission? Let me see your hands. Let me see how much of us are Seventh-day Adventists.
I am willing.
I am willing.
I am willing. Mm-hmm. Mark 15:16 says, "And he said unto them, Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Mm-hmm. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. All right. He that believeth not shall be damned." The great commander has made it clear for us to preach the gospel to all of his people, giving them the opportunity to follow him into his marvelous light or to remain in darkness. Mm-hmm. There are many souls who need us to bring the word of God to them in order to help rescue them from sin. Mm-hmm. Church, it is not up to us to decide anyone's fate. It is up to us to carry the word of God to them.
Help us, Lord. Amen.
As the remnant church and faithful Navy SEAL soldiers, let us vow to do God's work. The mission appointed is ours. The purpose is God's. Amen. This is my presentation this morning.
Amen.
Dear Lord, may your words continue to touch the hearts of many, and may the church vow to continue doing God's work.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, good afternoon. Once again, we are close to the end of our service, and we want to thank our dear brother, Brother Critchlow, for his message. I think it's about the first or second time, and we want to compliment him, and you know, we hope that he will go on from strength to strength. Mm-hmm. And some of you who are in the congregation who would have had an opportunity or no opportunity, we hope that your time will come as well. We want to close by the hymn number 340. 340. Okay.
Please stand. Give the wind
before we close, I just want to say something. It is very slight, and I hope that you will take it to heart and you will act on it. Now, I've realized from Sabbath to Sabbath when we come here to do our Sabbath worship that our attendance at the beginning of the service is not what it ought to be. And when we go into our divine worship, we come to a close, we have lots of persons here. I'm asking and appealing to you that you try and come a little earlier so that we can have a rousing song service and that more of you will be able to participate in our lesson study and as we conclude. And along with that, you can also bring a friend. Shall we bow our heads for prayer? Loving Jesus, we want to thank you for this day as the personal ministries department would have led out in the service. That we could have gone back into the field, into Kensington Lodge, King Street, King's Village, Hunt Street, Passage Road, New Orleans, Lightfoot Lane, and all the other areas that are within our district or within our area. We were also told of two crusades that will be starting soon, one with our dear pastor, Pastor Hoy, and one with Pastor Hall. We know, oh Lord, that whenever these things are about to take place, the devil seems to hit us in an area that we least expect. But we are told that when these things happen, like Jesus did, ask Satan to get thee behind us. And as we close, oh Lord, within the 7-10 day period that we should pray, may we pray from the depths of our heart, not only for the crusade, but ask God to help us to show the way that we should go in order to help other men, women, boys and girls to be a part of your kingdom. Like I've said before, we want to thank our dear brother again, Brother Critchlow, for the message that he would have presented. And we hope, oh Lord, that as he come again, that nerve that I would have seen in him will go away and he will get more confidence and give us more power. May you now take us to our home or to our homes or wherever she will go in peace and safety until Wednesday night when we shall meet again. In Christ's sake I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Six to six as we make our way outside. In a little while, we're going home.
Let us sing a song that will cheer us right away. In a little while we're going home. For the night will end in the everlasting day. In a little while we're going home. In a little while, in a little while, we shall cross the billows foam. We shall meet.
Sabbath.